Alright guys, today we have the Turnigy 9XR Pro Transmitter, sold by Hobby King. First off, you can see it's totally different than like the 9X, than just the 9X, but honestly it's not that much different in looks on the exterior from the 9XR. The only place it says 9XR Pro is right down here. That is it. It's kind of funny. But some upgrades, if you want to say, we've done to this is we've just put the $5 stand that comes with it, and that works really good. Also, back here, it has two trainer ports, JR and Futaba, which are nice. Your trainer switches and all that. I've not tried the trainer yet, but we'll try. Where the radio really shines is the interior, the software. It supports 24 channels. It comes with like 48 free mixes and stuff like that. It has, down here, it has, just we'll try and open this up so you guys can see. Right here, it has a mini USB, headphone jack, a power, like so you can charge your battery, and then a mini USB. So, that means you can upgrade this thing very easily. Alright, so then it has voice alerts, so when you turn it on, it'll talk to you.
Welcome to the 9XR Pro. Easy start.
And then if you have different stuff on, like sometimes you gotta go into the system and set up different, alerts that you want it to alert you. And then also this thing, it has 30 plus model memories, so right now I have 32 models on this remote compared to the 9XR, which had 16, I think, maybe. The remote is $99.99, so not a bad price for the remote, but you still gotta buy one of the modules. The FlySky module was $24.96 from eBay, shipped within a week, and then the orange module from Hobby King was like $30. And it shipped within 2 weeks or something like that. And then if you're doing FR Sky modules, you have to buy an extra plug that'll plug in to the back here and then plug into your module to give you full telemetry capability, because this also supports telemetry and it vibrates. So your timer counts down. Every time it goes like 8 minutes to 7 minutes, it says minute, which I don't like that compared to like Spectrum, where it says 7 minutes to land or whatever. But once it gets to 30 seconds, it says 30 seconds, then 20 seconds, then 10 seconds, then it counts down 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then it starts beeping and vibrating. So then also, you have all the different, these are dual rate switches. You got all the pots for different stuff. The trim tabs are different than a normal radio. They're more like rockers than they are clickers. So it definitely takes time to get used to. And then also this has 128x64 backlit liquid crystal display. So when it's turned on, it looks very nice. We have also bought the add-on for the white, so we can tell which radio is whose. And the white one right now has the FlySky module, and the like chromish one has the orange Spectrum DSM-2 module. Both work really good for, we have this one is just, the only thing we have is the Micro Striker from Park Zone, which flies great. And this, you know, you get it till you can't see it, the plane. Now, one thing I did have to do is, because we have the stand, there was one more bar that went right through here. But when you close it, it would hit on the back of this, so we just had to change that. So I have noticed that it is a little more difficult to program different stuff with this remote. Like, here, we'll turn it on, speak to us, and
so
what I found was like every way you go is a different page. So you hold the left arrow, it takes you to the radio setup. Zoom us in here. See, so you have the radio set up. You have 11 page of radio set up, which does a whole bunch of different things. Here you can calibrate your sticks. Then we have, you go to the right, and it has your model select. So here you can see, right here, 32 models of memory. And then, so you hold that, you go and you select your model. So you either have select, copy, move, or backup. So you hit select. So then you hit the right arrow again, and it takes you to the setup of that model. You have 13 pages of model setup. So here you have your name, the model name, the voice index, which is like different, how it speaks. So then here you have your voice index. Then you have your timer one, which I have set for 8 minutes. Then you have the trigger and trigger B. But so trigger one is when the throttle gets pushed up so much, the timer will start. So we go back here to the home page, and then you put the, let's say you're flying or whatever, the timer starts. But now when you're gliding around, if you're on a glider, then it stops when you're not using the engine. Also, if you're doing full throttle, it seems like it, the timer counts a little faster than when you're doing like half throttle. And then also, here's the mixer window. This is probably one of the most important windows you'll ever use, because it's the only way you're gonna be able to fly an airplane. So you gotta go up, and this is like, imagine this is your receiver. So what's channel one on your receiver? What do you plug in there? And I plug in aileron, elevator, throttle, rudder. So channel one is my aileron, channel two is my elevator, and channel three is throttle, channel four is rudder. And then also we have curves, custom switches, safety switches, telemetry two, and templates. So the templates is nice because you have a simple four channel plane, a T-cut, a sticky T-cut, a V-tail, a elevator, a delta, a heli setup, gyro setup, and then you have servo test, range test. And so it's nice, you know, if you just want a super simple four channel plane, just click that and it instantly pops it up on the mixer window over here. So then it's all over there, what it would need to be. So that's it for the internals of how confusing this radio can be. Alright, well, we'll see you guys later. Don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. And if you have anything else you'd like to see, just let me know. We'll see you guys later. Bye.